All right, after we shook it out, you can see there's a lot of different sizes of seeds here. Some of them aren't even seeds, but I think a lot of that is immature seeds, the tiny ones. But some of the bigger ones here, I think are mature enough that we can plant them. So this bunch here just broke off of the tree in the storm on its own. So its level of maturity might not have been perfect, but I think these are gonna work. So try to get the pods that you think are as swollen as possible when you gather them, so that they do open. If they're really not mature at all, they just won't open up at all, even when they dry out. All right, so let's plant them. To do that, to plant them, here are our peat pellets or peat pods, whatever you'd like to call them. And I'm just going to pour some water on them, and they will absorb the water and swell up. So you can see the size of them right now, maybe a centimeter high. So I'll put some water on them and they'll swell up. Let's go over to the sink. Move my dishes from breakfast. Okay. And we will give them a quick water. These will absorb quite a bit of water, so I'll put about a centimeter of water in there. I mean, if you put too much, they just won't absorb it, and you just dump the water out. It's not going to hurt them. If you don't have enough, you can always put more. And we just wait for them to swell up. Looks like they soaked up all that water. They are not quite all the way full, so I'm gonna go add some more water to them. Okay, I think that's probably good. They might soak up a little more. I'll leave the water in there for a while I get ready for the next steps. I'll get set up over here. All right, so we have our peat pellets. They've soaked up all of that water. They're not the most pretty peat pellets I've seen, but they'll work. And basically what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just open them up. And I don't want this thing to flip back over by accident and hit the seed, so it needs to either for sure not gonna do that or else rip it all the way off. That one I think is okay though. So I'm just gonna rip all of these open. They're already perforated, they have a spot for it. Pretty easy to do now that they're wet. And our seeds are gonna go right in there. Where this one's hanging weird. I'd rather have it a little bigger opening than not big enough where it's gonna fall back on those seedlings, on the little sprouts, and cover them up accidentally. I don't want that to happen. Some of them, like this one, didn't get perforated well when they were manufactured. It looks like the machine was off and did it there. Doesn't really matter. As long as they have a spot to grow out of and they're not gonna be covered up. Just rip them open a little bit. Probably if you got more expensive peat pellets, you're not going to run into that kind of problem, but I would rather save the money and rip a little more. There we go. And the last one here. Okay, that one came all the way off. That's fine. All right. So now I have all of the pellets opened up and we can put the seeds in. Before I sprinkled quite a few seeds in each one, and the plan was what didn't sprout, it didn't matter. I would just leave what's there that sprouted and maybe thin them out or distribute them. And if you look in the other video, that's possible to do that. But it took a lot of time, and I think it's better to take my time separating the seeds when they're not so fragile. I'm not worried about destroying the roots when I'm transferring them. I think it'll be easier to just separate the seeds out individually, and if they don't sprout, I'll have plenty more seeds to add into those peat pellets to replace the ones that don't sprout. So we'll see how that goes, and I'll get started with that. Okay, so to do that, I think if I take some kind of something that I can kind of get damp, I'm going to use these chopsticks, or one of them, and just kind of get it damp and use that to pick up individual seeds. So the goal is to only get one or two seeds in each peat pellet, and that way I don't have to thin them out. I can just let them grow. If I want to add more later, I can. So let's see how this goes here. There's plenty of little droplets on the edge of this thing, so I'm just gonna get this end of this damp, and we'll see how this works. I'm gonna pick out a larger one. So if you look carefully there, I have one seed on the end. That's just one. And I'm just going to transfer it gently into a peat pellet. You probably want to keep track, do these in a certain order so that you remember which ones you've put them in. All right, so I was able to transfer individual seeds from those ones I collected into each peat pellet. I believe I just got one in each. There's a possibility that I got more than one by accident, but I think I just got one. At any rate, it's going to be easier than having a whole bunch of them all grouped together and trying to separate them out without damaging those young sprouts. So yeah, it looks tedious, but this process is much less tedious than trying to separate these young little sprouts out of some soil or maybe a wet paper towel. Both those methods did work for sprouting the seeds. They worked really well, actually, but when it came to trying to transfer them into some soil or into peat pellets, it took quite a bit of effort. So that's why I'm using this method here. I don't know how long these are going to take to sprout. Last time they took about 12 hours is all. They're ready to go already the next day. You could start to see them sprouting. I've heard of them taking a few days. It probably depends on a lot of factors like temperature, for instance. So we'll see, and I'll update you when we see how they're doing. But thanks again for watching. If you want to see the rest of the videos in this series, please hit subscribe. Feel free to like and share, and we will see you in the next video. Thanks, everybody. See ya.